Do you see this bell icon here? Hit it now and we'll ensure you get delivered the very best of reviews, interviews and pop culture content.
I want to do a mainstream masala film.
Really?
Yeah.
Full on?
The event film.
Rohit Shetty.
Yes. Shetty sir, please. Rohit sir. If you're listening.
मैं ऑडिशन के लिए तैयार
हूँ. बॉडी मैंने बना ली है, बना सकता हूँ फिर से.
No hesitation on the next taboo subject. You'll jump in anyway.
Frankly speaking, बच्चे कहाँ हैं? सब तो कवर कर लिया है मैंने.
आयुष्मान, so lovely to have you again on Film Companion, but this time in person. It's so nice to see you.
Absolutely, same here. Thank you so much.
Listen, what has been the most unexpected reaction to Chandigarh Karyashki? Is there something like you weren't expecting, but which happened and which made you really happy?
A call from Hrithik.
Really?
Yeah, he called me and we spoke for 30 minutes. Huh. And he was like, whoa, what a film, man. I loved your character and you've inspired me. And it meant the world to me because I started my career as an anchor with him. He was the judge, I was the anchor on a dance reality show on a GEC. Huh. It just made my day because he being him, he was just praising the film for half an hour and praising my performance. And it really meant a lot.
How lovely.
Yeah.
That's so nice. And I think actors don't do it enough. We need to pick up phones on EV. I'm saying like I'm an actor, but but yes. You know, there needs to be more praise there.
Yeah. Absolutely. And other person is Ranveer Singh who loves to, you know, he's very expressive. After watching the trailer, he was like, bro, what body, ye wo, era. And he's also like full of love. Always.
Do you remember the last time we shot together? He was calling you what? 100 crore something.
Mr. ROI. Something.
Mr. ROI.
Yeah.
You had just had Bala, I want to say.
Yeah. Back to back, Andhadhun Badhai and Bala and Dream Girl, I guess.
Yeah, and he was like, it's 7 hits in a row. Yeah. Mr. ROI. You know, this film, Ayushman, of course, your character is so much about your physicality, right? And I was trying to figure out how do you say this without sounding really weird, but your thighs, just, you know, unbelievable. I was like, oh my God, these look like rocks. But Ayushman, there was that one scene, okay, in which you're telling her, your character, Manu is saying to Manvi that I didn't go to a great school. Like, I have no bandwidth to really understand. So it took me time to understand what you even told me. And I thought you did that scene so beautifully because I could really see this man struggling to be better than who he is. Mm. How did you do that? How did you get into his head so completely?
It was very easy to get into the head of that person because that's a representation of a common man in India who has no idea about the trans community.
Yeah.
I remember before doing this film, I was just talking to my watchman ki bhaiya batao ye ek mera dost hai, wo andar se sochta hai ki wo ladki hai. Lekin usne baad mein na apna operation karwa ke wo ladki ban gaya. Oh, he started laughing. kya mazak kar rahe ho sir, aise thodi hota. They have no idea.
Yeah.
That this exists or maybe there's a community who's also intelligent and have certain opinions. उनको आइडिया ही नहीं है. सो मनु मुंजाल्स कैरेक्टर इज अ रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ दैट पर्सन एंड हिम डूइंग द रिसर्च ऑन हिज ओन एंड लर्निंग अबाउट द कम्युनिटी एंड द एंटायर इमोशनल और फिजिकल ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन दैट अ ट्रांस पर्सन गोज थ्रू मीन्स अ लॉट. लाइक अगर मनु मुंजाल को समझ आ गया मतलब किसी को भी आ सकता है. सो दैट वॉज द होल थ्योरी बिहाइंड द कैरेक्टर.
वॉज इट ऑल्सो आयुष्मान बिकॉज of course you were not Manu Munjal, but you've talked in interviews about how when you were growing up in Chandigarh, you said you were very conservative, you were almost homophobic. You've talked about some club, an underground gay club in your school where they invited you and you said, I didn't go because I was too scared. But you've evolved along the way. Is this a character that you at some level knew?
Absolutely. At the same time, I would love to tell a story in 90s and mid 90s. There was this couple, though I belong to a conservative family, but my parents are still progressive, being from Chandigarh. In mid-90s, there were two girls in a hostel and they came to my father and one of them wanted to undergo this operation and become a boy. And my father suggested a gynecologist's name in Chandigarh and that person shunned them They're like, well, how can you go against nature? A doctor told them, you cannot do this.
Right.
It's not possible. And why do you want to do it?
Mm.
What's wrong with you? Aapko dimag ka ilaaj karana chahiye. That's what the doctor said to these girls. And my father was the only one who was supporting them. Ki aap aisa karo, kisi bade shahar mein jao. Maybe there they'll get you. They came to Bombay. The girl, she underwent this operation. And now they're married in Ludhiana for the past 20, 25 odd years. And I come from that background also.
Right.
So I knew about trans community when I was 13. So it was a great induction for me. Though I was also shocked ki aise thodi hota papa. And my father also didn't know that there's going to be an operation and it's going to be successful. So that was the first eye-opener for me that this is the community which exists and they think like that and they... And there's one line in the film jo psychiatrist bolte hai ki bhagwan ne galti kar di isne sudhar li.
Right.
It was as simple as that. So empathy was always there since childhood.
Yeah.
But yes, it takes time to, you know, we have grown a lot. We are learning every single day. We've evolved so much as society.
Yeah.
Like in college, yes, there was this gay community. They invited me and I just said no, but there was no malice for them.
Right. There was just fear because you there didn't understand.
Fear. Pata nahi mere sath kya karenge, mujhe pata nahi, I'm a straight guy, I don't know, I can't come, I just can't go, but you know, all due respect.
Yeah.
But like that.
Yeah.
I was not shunning them.
Correct.
Yeah.
Correct. Tell me, you know, the last time we talked, you had said, Ayushman, that before any film, you spend a lot of time talking to the director.
Hmm.
And really sort of breaking down what you're going to do, the film. So for this film, what was that conversation with Abhishek like? What did you really grapple with?
With this one, thankfully we have an Abhishek Kapoor who's tread this middle path and a very difficult, it's very difficult to make this film right from the inception to shooting and marketing and everything.
Yeah.
It's not a subject which is very, still not palatable for the masses.
Yeah.
It's very difficult. And I remember during Shubh Mangal Zyada Savdhan, I spoke to a lot of people in Chandigarh. And smaller cities, they were like, "Oh, क्या film आपने बनाई है? हम तो देखने ही नहीं गए. दो लड़के किस कर रहे थे. अब कैसी film बना रहे हो? So
what do you do when that happens?
I don't know. Then we thought about how to market this film because how can we just expose the subject if people are not going to theaters to watch a film on gay community? ये transfer है. तो कैसे करें? Then that's what we decided. We should not expose the subject. And it should give an illusion of a hetero romance. And then probably they'll discover the real subject while watching the film. And we were having multiple discussions with the director and how to go about it.
Mm.
And he was in touch with the community. I was in touch with the community, some members. And it happened. The idea was to have a director who's aware. And Abhishek is credible. He's a very credible director.
But Ayushman, when somebody says to you, ki ye film aapne kya bana di aur do aadmi kis kar rahe hain, hum to gaye nahi, does it ever put any doubt in your head?
It does, of course.
Really?
But at the same time, I've built my entire career by taking risks. So I have no other option. But the challenge was how to make it wider.
Yeah.
Sensitive, yes, and also wider.
You know, there's no, it's early days of going back into theatres, right? So there is no now wo jo fixed ki this is a good opening, this is not a good opening, right? But this film hasn't opened or done the numbers that your pre-pandemic films have done, correct? I read a piece in Box Office India about how that could be because now these films have become streaming films.
Mm.
Which really makes me sad because I don't want, I mean, I love streaming, but I want people to come to theatres for all sorts of movies.
Mm.
Do you think that what they're saying is true, that it's now only event movies in a big
I've realized that it has to be a family entertainer.
So not necessarily event, but something that appeals to everyone.
Yes, it should appeal to everyone.
Why?
Because that's the crux of community viewing. If it is not appealing to everyone, then I think you can watch it on OTT. If it's a dark film or a niche film, OTT is perfect for that, but it has to be a family entertainer. If you go out with your family and watching with strangers and having good time, that's what it means, and they'll choose their films accordingly.
Right.
That's what I've gained from the current scenario, and it's too early also to say because it's still 50%. Omicron is there, the new virus is there.
And it
will only improve. They are afraid, of course.
So it's, but you're right. So you're saying you have to sort of have the four quadrant appeal, old, young, men, women, and then they'll come to the theater.
Absolutely.
So not necessarily just an event. Does it, because you're the poster boy.
I think for theaters to survive, you need these mid-budget films to work.
You have to.
Because event films have only happened four times a year.
That's what.
So there is no other option.
Badai Ho wouldn't run today?
Absolutely.
It can't be.
It can't be. It's a family entertainer. It will. A Dreamgirl will run. A Bala will run. But of course, which just is a niche, slightly niche, a smaller audience that people may think twice before going.
But do you think that for you, this film, the risk paid off?
As a conversation starter, I think it's great. It's a great victory. I think the risk, in a way, we got great acclaim, critical, and people who are going, whoever is going is loving the film. So that's what I want to say.
But no hesitation on the next taboo subject. You'll jump in anyway.
Frankly speaking, बच्चे कहाँ हैं? सब तो cover कर लिया है मैंने.
This is true.
मैंने छोड़ा ही नहीं किसी के लिए.
List of अब ये It's all done.
मैंने सब खत्म कर दिया. So I guess the next one is Anek, which is a political thriller. Then I have a Doctor G, which is quirky, not a taboo subject. I'm a male gynecologist. Then I have an action hero, where I play a superstar who's known for action but can't fight in real. So it is a spoof on the industry only. So I think it's different, but it is not a taboo subject.
You know, a while ago, a couple of weeks ago, I was talking to Tahira about her new book, Seven Sins of Being a Mother, right? And I have great admiration for your wife. I think what you do on screen in fiction, she's actually doing in books, in non-fiction. She's talking about stuff that Indians just don't want to talk about, right? And it's amazing, you know, she's addressing guilt as moms, breastfeeding, you know, just the chaos of being a mother. And it's so refreshing to hear a woman voice these things, right? But I have to ask, because a lot of it involves you, including one amazing story about protein shake and breast milk. I just died laughing. I was like, Tyra, that is just unbelievable.
We are still arguing over that scene, that situation. I remember we were in Thailand that time, and she thinks that I thought that the housekeeping has taken that away, and she's like, where is my breast milk? No, I didn't have it. The housekeeper, she took it away. And then I was like, having a protein shake, nahi tune isme dala hai. Mere ko nahi, maine isme nahi dala hai. So we are still arguing on that.
So she's just maligning you, basically.
Absolutely. अगर वो यहाँ पे होती, she'll probably fight again and start arguing again. मैं नहीं पिया यार.
Tell me, do you ever have conversations in life when, as you're going through things together, when you tell her कि यार ये किताब में मत लिखना, वो होता है कभी?
I think that's her life also. She has all the right to do whatever she wants to. But I am very different as a person.
Yeah.
I am very private and she's out there. So we are very different individuals, but that's yin and yang, of course. But that's how we complete each other.
No, but because the stories involve you, how does it work?
It's fine. I think
it's good. You're fine with it.
I'm okay with it. Yeah.
Which is so lovely.
Yeah.
You've like, just made your peace.
मैं embarrass, मैं ऐसी फिल्में करता हूँ जो वहाँ embarrass नहीं होता, तो यहाँ पे क्या embarrass होगा?
Which is lovely, Ayushman. I think to sort of just be chilled about it is just a wonderful thing, because genuinely I think when she writes and talks about these things, it helps a lot of people. You know, it really does.
Yeah,
because
of course.
Hear, you're like, wow, I'm not alone. There's somebody else who felt like this.
Yeah.
Tell me, we had talked about this earlier, but next year, 10 years, right? What are the things that give you joy as an actor now, and are they different from when you started?
Joy as an actor. that you are a different person every time, and there is no 9-to-5 job. There is no schedule, and as an artist, you just need that in life, that you have to get up this time in the morning and follow this routine. Routine is dangerous. And that's what is the best part of being an artist.
And what keeps you up at night?
Up at night.
Is there anything that is sort of scary now?
As an artist, you always have that little bit of insecurity and security, because you cannot thrive if there is no insecurity. You have to be, the idea is to be just what to do next, how to take this next step or decision. After reading hundreds of scripts, you decide on one project. So it'll always be there. And security gives you happiness. So it's again a fine balance of security and insecurity. So I'm a night person, so it keeps I'm up at night. Tyra's a day person. But yes, that's the balance I want to do.
You know, like you said, Ayushman, you've done all the taboos, right? Yeah. I mean, seriously speaking also, you've done a lot of them, correct? So, ab, as an actor, what would you like to do? You know, like you're talking about this, it's a spoof on the industry, or there's a cop drama. Are there things that you want to do that you haven't done so far?
I want to do a mainstream masala film.
Really?
Yeah.
Full on?
The event film.
Rohit Shetty.
Yes. Shetty sir, please, Rohit sir, if you're listening.
मैं audition के लिए तैयार.
Body मैंने बना ली है, बना सकता हूँ फिर से.
This is true.
Yeah, so I can do that as well.
This is true. Yeah. Those thighs would work in a Rohit Shetty.
Oh my God, so difficult. 120 kgs of squats daily. Oh my God.
Yeah. That's amazing.
Yeah.
That is amazing. Mm. So you want to do like full blown song, dance, action, romance.
Why not?
I love it.
I would love to. Yeah. I've grown up watching Hindi masala films. I would love to do at least one masala film every year. I would love to.
You think Ayushman, they don't think of you when they're writing that they say, nahi, nahi, wo to hatke hai.
Agar main wo karunga, tabhi meri Article 15, Anek, jaisi filmen chalengi.
Yeah.
So it's very important.
वो चल रही हैं Article 15.
मतलब और चलेंगी. You know, I think
this is true, yeah.
the true victory will be when a film like Article 15 does 100 crores.
Yeah.
Instead of 60-65, which is great for that film.
Yeah.
But if that film does 100 crores in theatres, it'll be great. But for that, I need to do masala films.
So that's next.
I hope. I really want to. There'll be one, I think, next year. Let's see.
Really?
Yeah, yeah.
Ajay, can you tell us about anything you've signed right now, after the three films that you've already told us about?
I have signed one which is a commercial masala film.
Nice.
Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah.
And the announcement will be?
Will be next year. Yeah.
That's so exciting.
Tell me,
this genre that you created, the Ayushman Khurana space, uska kya hoga?
Wo bhi hoga. I think it will coexist. It's not just social
like
issues, it's
also... Like theatre and streaming.
Why?
Like theatre and streaming.
Like theatre and streaming.
Your masala version and your original version will coexist.
Yes, yes. The idea is to make wider films. They have to coexist. And as I said, a lot of times it's my staple genre. And it doesn't only include socially driven, message oriented films.
Yeah.
It also includes quirk and a lot of novelty and unsaid things. So yeah, it will always exist. And taboo subjects khatam nahi hue hain hamare desh mein, bahut taboo subjects hain. Jis shahar mein jao aapko ek mudda mil jayega. So it will be there.
Tell me, before we end, how do you choose, like, what is the process of a script coming to you? How does somebody out there with a great idea actually access Ayushman?
Could be anything, like right from sending your script to Yashraj Films, or just a direct message to me or any of the fan clubs.
Matlab DM on Instagram?
DM anywhere on Twitter.
Nahin,
I think kahin se bhi aa sakti hai. Achha idea.
And, but you're looking, or your people are looking.
Listen, people are looking.
Huh.
They are open to everything, because I believe that it's not just the top filmmakers or script writers who can give you a great idea. It can come from anyone.
Absolutely.
Half of my films are with first time filmmakers and first time script writers. So I have mere ko aur mehnat karni hai isme, because I need to keep my eyes and ears open. A good idea can come from anywhere.
Yeah. So that's a big note for everybody out there.
Yes.
Instagram, Twitter.
Anywhere.
Yashraj.
Yeah.
bombard you with new ideas.
Yes, my digital team is there. They'll filter out and they'll give it to me. Yeah.
Do you read most scripts?
I.
Do you read most of the, like, most, how does it work?
They filter out for me.
Okay.
Yeah. They filter out for me, though. If they're hundreds, I'll probably read 10 if they're good. Mm. Yeah.
Nice. Well, listen, I'm sure there are lots of people out there who have stories for you. And this was a great, you're absolutely right. Chandigarh Kare Aaj Ki is a great conversation starter. And I hope it'll give people courage to make more.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
If you like this video, subscribe to Film Companion.